Digimon is one of the newer card games to come out. With so many starter decks and packs to pick from, where do you even begin? With a budget of only $20 a week, without trading or buying singles, can I get my invite to Nationals? This is what I set out to find, and I would like to invite you to come along with me on this perilous journey. Let's get this digital gate open. If you've been enjoying my series so far, why not join my Patreon? You'll get access to videos early as well as feature duel against me for a video. Join in the description below. Alrighty then, guys. So this week we're going to be doing a little bit of a Jeopardy thing, and we're going to be doing this every single week going forward until we get every single one of the cards that we need from this filled out. These are little prizes that our biggest fan, Krista Quill, has created for me specifically on this, just to make it have a bit more fun with it. But yeah, for every single one of these that we open, we get to flip it over and see what we get. So this week we are going to be opening two BT6, two BT7, and one Gallant Mon starter deck. People have been asking a lot about this one. They've been wanting to specifically have this one just because of a lot of stuff like Terra Forces and all that stuff. Gaia Force. Terra Force is the old name of the card. But yeah, this is what we have going for us. In total, this week we spent about... it was still $22. We had a budget left over of $24 from last time. So we still have $2 left over. Unfortunately, there's nothing we can get for that much. So we're just going to go ahead and do this. We're going to keep this one going first. This one's going to be a bit of a longer opening, so I do apologize about that. Just because we have a starter deck we have to open here. But this will be a great help to us simply because of the fact that, it's a starter deck. Oh, thank you, Krista Quill, giving me some help here. You got a knife there?
Ducky.
Probably should have opened this before.
Ooh.
Good enough. Thank you.
Did it help?
Yeah, I did. Or maybe not. Oh well, we'll just cut this in the footage in the editing, so it's not too bad. But yeah,
did you get it?
Yeah, I got it. So yeah, that's pretty much what we have going on this week. My past couple of weeks have not been the best. As you know, I was sick and I had to leave the last one, so we didn't get too many games, just two, which is unfortunate, but it happens. I believe that's it in that one. Thank you. We're gonna go ahead and see what we get from these. So these come with memory boosts, which are absolutely fantastic because they help us search our cards. We're gonna go ahead and grab the red memory boost, and yeah, that's pretty much all we need from this one. They got one of each color, which is fantastic. I'm pretty sure these are getting reprinted in the reboot set, but oh well. Let's see what we get here. So there is a new egg we can use from this. We got the Gigimon. It's a pretty decent card. We also got Monogramon. We don't really need that. The Agumon here is actually pretty good because it gives a plus 2,000 DP when it's swinging. We are going to be adding... Come on. There we go. Some of these cards stick because they're a bit old. We got a Gilmon. This Gilmon is amazing. I'm honestly going to add that to the deck just because of how good it is. A blocker. We don't really need that. Growlmons are pretty decent. These Geogreymon might end up going into the deck just because they blow things up when they're played in security. So it's not a bad idea. We got some cheap evolution here. We don't really need that. Some Groundramon. Again, nothing we really need. Rise Greymon. It's okay. On play, it does something. Where Groundmon is a maybe, just because of the fact that it gets plus one security if a Digimon got deleted on your opponent's side. Which isn't too bad, which is 100% a possibility. We got Gallantmon as well, which is what the starter deck is based off of. Plus one security, it's a three cost, and when it swings, it deletes a Digimon with 4,000 DP or less. And if no Digimon was deleted, you get plus 3,000 DP for the turn, which is actually pretty great. We can also search this out because it is a Royal Knight, so that's a thing. This Shine Greymon's not too bad. It just has plus one security and like piercing. I might end up adding this. I don't know. It just depends. We got some Lightning Joust. They're not too bad. Atomic Blasters are a huge maybe just because we need more things that delete the entire board because we don't have any Crimson Blaze, and Gaia Forces obviously are a must. Some other stuff as well. But yeah, that's kind of it with this one. We're going to go home and start with a BT7 here. Thank you. Let's see what we get. Let's hope we get something good out of the BT7. I just hope, because all we really need are commons and some rares. So we got a Philmon, Eismon, Scatter Mode. I love this card so much. Shellmon, Triceramon, Dorugoramon, or Dorugamon, my bad. Flame Memory Boost. This one's a maybe. Loemon, Cocomon. We got a Rhino Kabuterimon, Nidhoggmon, and for our first rare, we have an Evolution Ancient, and it looks like we have something really nice in the back. I don't know what we're gonna get. Maybe a secret rare, who knows? And, oh, never mind. It's a Dino Rexmon. That's disappointing. Not the best thing in the world, but hey, it's there. All right, onto a BT6 pack. I am amazed that out of all these packs, we haven't been able to open a single, like, Huckmon. Even in BT7, we can't seem to get a Huckmon or another Sistermon, which really strange. Do you mind getting these out of the way, please? Thank you. We got a Ferrismon, again, Bakomon, Pangamon, Mammothmon, Glaive Memory Boost, Madoki Betamon, Megadramon, Bibimon, Acid Injection, Gualt Schwarmer, a Red Reamer, and the next card is going to be an Altart Gankumon. Okay, another Altart.
Do we have a Ganku on our board?
We do not. We have the X Antibody, but we got the Altart, which is pretty cool. That's actually really sick. We're going to go ahead and set this one aside. Unfortunately, not something we were looking for. But hey, but it is a Royal Knight, so we could end up using it. That's kind of weird that we've been getting so many like Royal Knight, just Altarts. I'm going to probably play it just because of the Altart. We got a Grumblemon, a Tortlemon, Kendogurumon, Monitamon, Gigastorm. Gigastorm's actually kind of good because it deletes up to 2 Digimon with 8 KDP or less. Tidal Wave, Ultra Turbulence, Starlight Velocity, Ancient Volcanomon, Aldemon. We got our first rare here, and it is a Strabimon and a Ancient Kazemon. Still no Huckmon. This is disappointing. No Huckmon, no Sistermon. Now let's see what we can get off of this double diamond pack, because it's not looking good here. We got an Altart. Again, it's like every single week we get an Altart. It's weird. Or a secret rare. But let's see what we get off of this one. We're going to go ahead and do Tinkermon, Petaldramon, Strabimon, Boogiemon, Gigadramon, Tapirmon, Octomon, Gabumon, I don't know why I said Gaburimon, Toropiamon, Pagumon, and then our first rare is a Rattlestar, and a TK Ankari Kamiya. Still no Huckmons or any more Sistermon Blancs. Oh well, that's just how the cookie crumbles. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and get to the deck list right after this. There's really no changes since we didn't get anything, but hey. We do have changes, actually. Never mind. We do have the Gallimon starter deck. So hey, at least we got some useful things. Anyways, thank you for watching this part.
Before we begin the deck profile, I noticed a lot of you aren't subscribed. Why not subscribe today and hit that bell icon to get notifications for more Digimon to the Top? Now, onto the deck profile.
Alrighty then, so here's our deck list from the previous week, and we're going to go ahead and have some changes here. We're going to go ahead and take out a Solarmon and a Candlemon for another card. We're going to go ahead and put in 2 Gilmons from the starter deck that we just opened. We're going to go ahead and take out a Meramon simply because we don't need it anymore and because Geogreymon is a much better Digimon for it. We're going to go ahead and take out the Aceramon. Aceramon is not as good as a Gigadramon because of the lower cost and everything. We're going to go ahead and take out one of our alpha mons right over here, the only one we pulled so far, and we're going to go ahead and put this gallant mon replacing it. We're going to go ahead and take out for master disciple for a red memory boost, and then take out from fire blast fire father and the onslaught for a 2 Gaia forces. And that is today's deck list. Hopefully you like it.
Alrighty then, so today we're facing our friend Tanner here. We're going to be going first, which is fantastic. He's playing his D-Reaper deck, and I'm playing with my new cards, obviously, with my Gilmon and other stuff like that. D-Reaper is an interesting matchup because it should technically be a pretty good matchup for me, simply because of the fact that I can swing into his mother D-Reaper pretty easily. But instead what happens is I make a lot of misplays this game. I don't know why, but I just did. I was consistently put at around 1 to 2 memory this entire game, which is, you know, normal. That's what Mother D Reaper does a lot. But we were able to put out some pressure. Unfortunately, that Solarmon got taken down by a Starsmon, which really sucks. X Antibody is such an interesting card for the deck because it does add a source, which means it can play things for cheaper and have other cards come out faster, like such as D Reaper or something else like that. But it's not too bad of a matchup. I just don't know what's going on with me on this one. I've been playing pretty badly. I just don't know why I've been playing this badly for a while now. For like the past, I would say, 2 matches, I've been pretty iffy. But this one is just, you'll get to see it later on. So we get some stuff going on. We got our Jessmon going. We leave him at 1. We're able to swing for 2 checks. And we are able to attack into the Jerry. Not the Jerry. It was the, I believe it was a Gatekeeper. No, it was a... It was the ADR Searcher. And then he gets Bubbles out from the security. Bubbles is going to go ahead and attack some stuff. And then look at the top 5 with Jerry. Grabbed 1, attached it. I really like D-Reaper as a concept. It's very simple. I have no problems with the deck. I'm just the one who's been misplaying a lot. Now, I will say, Gatekeeper is really annoying. That card stops me from doing so many things. I don't know why. I feel like it's a really way too good of a card. But we were able to get some more pressure going on here and swing in for at least 1 check because we still get the +1 security check from, the effect of our boy. And we're going to go ahead and evolve into our Jessmon, which is fantastic. That'll at least give us all 3 checks that we need. And we're going to go ahead and put the Gallimon that we had previously. Gallimon will help us out here, and we get to put 2 checks out, 3 checks out, actually. But we hit another Gatekeeper, which is, you know, I don't like that. Hey, what are you going to do? Now there's -2. if I had a Judgment of the Blade here, I would absolutely be able to take out that Mother D Reaper. But I don't think I drew one this entire game, which really sucked because I really needed it. I'm not a fan of, you know, losing because of that fact. But hey, things happen. And he's got everything going now. He's going to swing everything right now because he most likely has the D Reaper in hand. Let's see. He goes in with Jerry, and let's see, with his, yep, another security, with his Gatekeeper. Gatekeeper's gonna take out another security. Pendulum Feet, another one. We get an Izzy. We would have been saved here if there are 3 black, but there unfortunately is less black in the deck now that I took out those security bombs. But oh well, we're at least gonna get a Jessmon next turn, if that's a possibility, I guess. And then we're going to go ahead and get swung into by the Starsmon. And now the last checks are going to be by the Reaper. Reaper's really annoying. It's huge. It's 17,000 on its first swing, which is insane. But that's just how it happens. That's just how it goes. Nothing you can do about 17,000, which really sucks. And then it restands itself. It's a really cool mechanic. Alright, and then on our second game here with Tanner, we're just going to go ahead and go first again since we did lose. We had a terrible hand, we had no level 3s, and we gave him 5 memory to get set up here. Or was it 6? I don't remember what the cost is of that Digimon. But we were able to at least go into a Gigadramon, which isn't too bad. It's been pretty fun with it. I like Gigadramon, I think it was a really nice inclusion, simply because of the fact that it made my Jessmon way bigger during their turn. With the CL and everything, it made Jessmon go all the way up to about, under my opponent's turn, I should say, made it go all the way up to about 15,000. It is 15,000 perpetually. And if I have anything like the Bauhawk that's right under it, it's at 16,000, which is pretty huge. You can't really kill that thing at that point. Actually, no, you're at 17, because 2,000 plus 2,000 is 14. It's, 14... Yep, 16. Yep, 17. Pretty big. We go ahead and do a Master and Disciple here. We lose our Izzy, but we get some more cards back. Our Solarmon is in the back. We're going to go bring that up next turn, which is going to be fantastic, because then we can stop certain plays. We're going to go ahead and hit for 2 checks. We got him on the ropes here. We're going to go ahead and swing with our CL here, and we hit a Bubbles. And right now we're in a very good spot. All we need is one more swing and we end up winning the game. Now, I made a few mess ups here because I cannot believe what I did. But he ends up putting out his searcher. Bubbles kills my CL, that's absolutely fine. Brings out a Jerry so then he can, you know, do the Jerry stuff. And then during my turn, not during my turn, you're gonna see what he brings out. It's annoying. He brings out a, that thing. And the problem that I had was that I had absolutely no way to get rid of it at the time. So I just had to digivolve up. I did go into a Jessmon. Now here's the thing. I could have won if I didn't swing into that because I could have swung into the Mother D Reaper. It was such a bad play on my part. It was just so bad. I don't understand why I did that. That was just horrible. What kind of idiot does that? Like seriously. What was the point of me doing that? Yeah, I got rid of that, but you're gonna see here what happened. It's so unfortunate because I would have actually had game at this point if I did not flub it up that horribly. We have enough memory here to go into like a Jessmon GX and get several checks. If another gatekeeper pops up, which it does, his security was just crazy. And at that point we just lose because we can't do anything about it. We just can't do anything about it because we messed up so badly on that. I don't understand why I went for this play, but I did. We do have a blocker on board that is gigantic, but that Starmon's puts us down to about, I would say, 14,000, 14,000, 15,000, which is huge, but like, it's not enough to stop what would have been a Reaper. We were able to get that thing out of the way, but you know, not too bad. I just don't understand why I did these things so horribly. It's so bad. But he's going to go ahead and go into his Reaper and just end it here. He's got 3 checks left. It doesn't matter. He has about, I believe, 4 checks that he can do with it because of the 7 materials and anything else that was sent in the trash from security. So it's huge. I was off by 1,000. 1,000 DP would have killed that thing. So sad. It just happens, though. You got to learn from your mistakes and get better at this. Hopefully next week I don't make as bad of mistakes, but I feel like I just did horrible this time around. I don't know what's going on with me. I apologize about it, but hey, next time we'll be able to do better. We gotta keep our hopes up. Maybe we'll get more Huckmons, who knows. But hey, this game was actually really fun. I had a ton of fun doing this one, and I'm so thankful to Tanner for allowing me to do this because I picked a random deck. I think he was gonna pick Jessmon or something else, but hey, I'm actually really happy about this, and I'm showing him that, hey, I have the Judgment of the Blade. I had it for next turn, but I ended up dying. So yeah, good games to Tanner. All right, we got clapped by Mom Cheeks today. We got last place. We didn't do too well. It was only a 2-round tournament, but I got a bye. But here is the pack. We're gonna see what we get, and it looks like we got another Gammamon. That's kind of fantastic. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this week's video. I hope to see you guys next week. Just like and subscribe for more. Peace out. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this week's video, make sure to like and subscribe for more content. If you would like to further support this series, join my Patreon in the description below. See you all next week, and keep that digital gate open.